All right, we ready to go?
Which side in front?
That one. Ryan will be teaching this one.
What?
West.
I want to be a
back. Just grab a little spot wherever you want to be. So I'm going to first just kind of, I'm going to go over the what and the why of this stuff. I know this is a little foreign. One of the really cool things about it, the resistance training, so it's been going on for decades. When I was in college, we were doing bands and chains and all those things. But the cool thing about it, the reason that we're incorporating it, is it allows you to move through the planes of motion that you would down there, but it is lighter on your joints. You can make this as heavy as you want, but it also at the same time is a little bit more core involved than you would with the barbell because of the positioning of it. So again, you can see down here with the bands, it goes all the way up to 125 pounds. That's when it's singular, but when it's doubled over, that thing can get extremely heavy, all the way down to 15 pounds. So it's a really cool variation that you can use. But again, the whole point of the variable part of it is once you get it extended and it's all the way up, I don't think I have this one engaged, but. So once I get this thing all the way to here, this is extended and it's actually pretty heavy. But once it comes down, there's a lot less resistance on it. So if I had this up on my shoulders, pretend I had the bar in my hand, and I came down like this, now that's a lot less than it is right here. The good part about that is most of the time what happens when you're down there, or you're using free weights, kettlebells, whatever, what can happen is we lose our posture when we're down at the weakest part. So down here, this is the weakest part of our position, and we might lose the spinal position, our knees might move, our feet might move, or on the way up, I might go first with my glutes, and then my back has to compensate for that. That's the cool part about this, is that when I have a bar and it's free, when you add gravity and speed, well, then you put more pressure on you. It's the exact opposite of this. So as I get down into those positions, now I can solely focus on my core, and my posture, my positions, which is the best part about it. And so there's research that has shown the reversal of osteoporosis, which is actually kind of mind-blowing that you can do that with just this. We all know the research is out there that talks about the use of resistance training, especially as we age, how important resistance training is. But unfortunately, a lot of people, when you hear resistance training, you hear heavy weightlifting, and that's not always what it means. So even incorporating this into a weightlifting routine is pretty widely done, even if you've ever heard of Westside Barbell, which is a very famous weightlifting club. They use this stuff. They go through this stuff. They use the chains and the bands and all that kind of stuff as a supplement to some of their workouts as they go in between heavy days. So it's a really cool supplement. And in some cases, like for myself even, I like using it. I use it all the time. So even when I have weight on the bar, instead of adding an extra however much weight, I just throw bands on. Because I really like the feeling of the eccentric side of it. So when I'm going down, it's a much more controlled position. It really makes me focus on my knees, my abductors, my abs, and my spinal position because I'm getting that force as I come down, which is, I really enjoy that. And then once I get down here, that force is almost gone and I feel really strong in this position. Now I'm in a better position to come out. And I always feel a lot better after working out with these and thus this. So one of the common mistakes that happens with these things though is because bands are starting to become more popular, which is pretty cool. If you were to take this, you know, I'm sure you guys have seen them where you can buy them in a package and use them as your travel workout and all that kind of stuff in these bands. One of the problems is the only way to do it is this. And so if you start doing stuff like this, some people will collapse their feet. Because of the pulling of the band, you might collapse your feet. If you collapse your feet, you collapse your knees. If you collapse your knees, so now my back and my abs aren't set properly. That becomes a problem. Thus, that was created. So I was like, there's gotta be a way that we can use bands and we can do all this stuff and make it functional, but not worry about all this stuff. So that's why these are built. So there's only 10 of them. I got asked in one of the other groups if we would like make these so you could have them at home. Like, well, we only have 10 right now. So not saying it can't happen. It just, this is all we got. So I built as many as I could in the time that I had. And then maybe at some point we can have some more out there. So what I wanted to do today, what we wanted to do today, is just go through a quick joint by joint mobility real quick, just to get the body fluid and moving a little bit. and then feel it. So we're gonna go through some arm movements, we're gonna go through some handle movements, go through some isolated shoulder stuff, and just let you feel what this feels like and feel the resistance and you know what it feels like to go into those movements. And so what our suggestion is going to be today is that we focus on the lighter weights. Now, for some of you that maybe worked out this, well, you worked out this morning, if you wanna go a little bit heavier because you're used to going heavier, go for it. But we're gonna probably stick to these guys. And these guys here. So I would say from here to here is what we're using today when we connect to the bars. And then there's two different methods of how to connect to the high. There's two different methods of how to connect to the bar. So we're calling it method one and method two just to keep it simple. But this is method one, so there's one part of the band underneath, and that keeps it longer, and it keeps the resistance a little bit lighter. And then if you wanted a challenge, you wanted to go heavier, then you would put both of them underneath, and it would clip in like this, which we'll show you when we get to that. But it can add a significant amount of weight when you do that. So, but we're gonna show you that. So, are there any questions about that, or what we're going to do, or any of that? No? Oh, don't be nervous. We won't keep you super long. It's already late in the day, so we're going to try to get through what we can get through by about 7:45, and then that'll give us a little bit of time if you want to ask questions or we have any thoughts or concerns or whatever, you can throw that out there. Cool? Okay, so we're going to go through, again, the joint mobility, a little explanation as we go through. I know a lot of you guys are familiar with it, but if you're not, we're going to go through some of it. So we're gonna go from the ankles to the knees to the hips to the back to the neck, do a little bit of shoulder work, and then we'll go into some body weight movement prep prior to actually using the bands and the bars and everything. Okay? So first things first, we're gonna go ankles. So foot straight out in front of you, internally rotate the foot like this. We're gonna open up that ankle joint. So you feel that stretch on the outside wall of your foot. Okay, so there's three major parts to your ankle joint. This part, we're gonna do five of these, by the way, and when you're done with five, switch to the other foot. That part, the part that you are stretching right now, where that joint goes, the nerve that travels through that joint actually controls your hamstring and your glutes. So if you imagine walking around all day and you're compressing the outside wall of your foot like that, and then by the end of the day, your back hurts at the end of the day, part of that is because these weren't turning on at full capacity, and then all the pressure's going from your knee to your back. So this is even when you're during the day, just doing that and just opening up that ankle will make a lot of stuff feel better. Now we're gonna go inside. So just pull your knee away from your foot and let that inside wall of your foot open up like that. That part of the inside of your ankle actually goes right into your hip flexor. So just once you do five, we're gonna go to the other side. One, two, three, four, and five. We're gonna do ankle circles. So one important thing, never practice falling. So if we're ever doing something and you feel off balance, find a wall. So we're gonna do an ankle circle. So one foot's on the ground, one foot is up. If you feel like you're gonna be off balance, put your hand on the wall. We're gonna do three circles that way, three circles the other way. Good, switch. One, two, three, and then switch. One, good. Take that out. Now we're going to go up to our knees. When you do your knees, we have about hip width here. Slight knee bend. Now what you're going to do is we go into these knee circles is what we call them. But then there's a half hula hoop right here. And you're just touching your knees to the hula hoop. So drop your hips and just circle the knees. We're going to do three circles this way. Stop and go the other way. Three circles this way. Good. Good. Take that out. Now we're going to go hip pendulum. We're going to bring our leg up into 90 degrees here. And then what you're going to do is we're going to swing it back and forth. We're trying to get the femur bone that goes into the pelvis and just kind of move around and move that whole joint up. So you're just going back and forth. And if you need a wall, use it. We're going to do eight swings. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then switch feet. There's two other variations of that we'll get into, but for today, we'll just go here. Good. Okay, take that out. Now we're gonna go into a hip circle. So 45-degree lunge step. One leg is bent, back leg is like an iron rod. So from your hip to your heel, leg is straight. Now what you're going to do from this position, you're going to go around the hula hoop, and as you come forward, you should feel stretch in that hip right there. Or you go three circles this way, and now go the other way. Three circles the other way. One, two, do you guys feel that in the hip? And you want to use that glute that's in the back as you come to the front. Squeeze that glute muscle and push into the hip. Okay, now switch. Same thing. Squeeze the glute as you come forward and push into that hip so that your pelvis goes straight and it doesn't turn sideways. Do three that way and then three the other way. Good. Good. Okay, now we're going to go into the lower back. I'll demonstrate first before you guys do it because there are some minor common mistakes when guys, when people do this. So one of the mistakes, all we're trying to do is open up the lumbar spine right here that can get really, really tight. So we don't want to overdo this. So it's really important to just take your time with it. So you have a slight knee bend, you're going to drop your shoulder, and then you're going to take this shoulder and drop it too, so it's like everything's hanging. So your shoulder blades and everything are just long. And then you're going to think about drawing a rainbow with your nose and come to the other side, and then you're going to open up here and then come all the way around, not too far, and then back down. Now one of the mistakes that people make is they do this really fast, and they'll go here and they'll go like that, and we're putting way too much stress on our lower back. We don't need to do that. The whole point is just move. So here, and just lightly go around, come up, don't go beyond comfortable there, drop it, do two circles in one direction, and when you're done, stop, open up, and go the other direction twice. Keep a slight knee bend, and then keep your feet about hip width. Make sure your balancing structure is good. And the whole point is just let your both arms and back just kind of fall into place. Good. So now we're going to our thoracic spine. So we're just going to do a quick little movement, get all those muscles warmed up. So again, 45-degree lunge step, nice and small. It doesn't need to be long like the hips. Now what we're going to do is whatever leg is in front, you rotate to that leg and then pretend there's a ledge right here. Hunch over the ledge and just let everything hang. And now it's like you're wringing out your spine back and forth like this. So watch how I let my arms hang, and I'm just rotating back and forth, and I'm opening up my shoulder blades as much as possible, like I'm wringing out my back, and I'm just moving those muscles around. Once you've done about 6 to 8 of those, switch your feet to the other side. Just let everything hang, and then open it up. Let your arms just kind of hang there. Should make your upper back feel pretty good. And once you're done, stand up straight. We're going to go into the cervical spine, so your neck, essentially. So we're going to start, we're going to go four in each thing. So back and forth, one, two, three, four. And now we're going to go ear to shoulder, one, two, three, and four. And now chin to shoulder, one, two, three, four. And then we're going to do a cervical push. So you're starting your chin here, push it out, and bring it back. Bring it out and push it back, four of those. Now the reason we're doing this, a lot of times when people put their body under stress, so they're lifting or they're doing something, they'll be, we call it a neck driver. So you'll end up doing this to try to do something, and we want you to feel that strain and then come back to that neutral position. You're so much stronger and better balanced when you're here. We never want to push here. So even if you're at work or you're in front of a computer or you're doing something, if you start noticing yourself doing this, do a couple of those glides and feel yourself come back to neutral, and then relax your shoulders and try to stay neutral. So just something you can do throughout the day. Okay, so how does everybody feel? Good. Does anybody know what your vestibular system is? I know you know. You should know. Yeah. Oh yeah, so you have liquid in your inner ear that's like a leveler. And that tells your brain when you're balanced. And so sometimes if you get a little lightheaded or you feel a little off like that, that's your vestibular system, a little off kilter. So one, I'm gonna show you how to fix that. But two, when we move, anytime we go into any type of movement prep, you wanna make sure that both the vestibular system and your ocular nerve, what you're seeing, are coordinated. So you'll probably, like some of you that watch the kids out here do it, you're probably like, what the heck are they doing? Well, that's what we're doing. So this is called vestibular ocular reflex, is what it's called. And so you're gonna give yourself a target. So I want you to think about, as you're doing this, toes are straight. I want you so like centered and balanced that it feels like your feet are grabbing the ground. So knees are slightly bent, abs are engaged. You're gonna give yourself a target. So stick your thumb right out in front of your nose. Now, as you're looking at your thumb, you're gonna move your head up and down slowly, but keep your eyes fixed on your thumb. Do not take your eyes off of your thumb. What you're doing is you're getting that ocular nerve to react and stay engaged with something while moving that liquid around in your brain. So now that your body and your brain connection are going, okay, I feel safe. Everything's moving, I'm not falling, everything's fine. So after you've done about 6 to 8, now go side to side. So same thing, and move it side to side. And then the better we get at this, the more advanced we get with this, we can do this from a single leg, we can do this walking, we can do this in a bouncing position. And then we start moving our head diagonal and all that, but that's down the line. Okay, you guys actually like, it's weird, but you feel a little like loose and warmed up, and we didn't even really move yet. It's kind of a cool feeling. So, and again, like the more you do this, these are things you can use all day throughout the day. Like if you watch us ever, like I'm sitting there talking to people and like doing my ankles. Or assuming like move my shoulder, my wrists, you know, or I'll kind of move my knees a little bit, and that's what I'm doing. What you just did is what I'm doing out there all day, every day. So, what we're gonna do first, so if you can clear off your platform there, get everything off of it. We're gonna do a couple movement pattern things, body weight, just so you get familiar with standing on the platform. That's one of those, you're not used to standing on stuff probably to exercise. So we wanna do a couple things first. So the first thing we're gonna do is just a body weight squat. Now the cool thing is the logo that's there can give you some visual targets. So what I want you to do is as you stand on this, I want your feet right outside the logo. So you should be able to see the entire logo. Now that little line that's coming out that separates where the top and the bottom of the words, that should be pointed right into your arches. That's where we want your foot position. So we're gonna do a couple body weight squats. We're gonna do 8 of them. And we're gonna do a pause squat is what it's called. So whole point of this, I want the toes straight, I want the knees straight. I'm not asking you to go all the way down. We're gonna go halfway and pause. So all we're going to do is as we come down, and I'll do it sideways, you guys see it. I want to think about my spine and my shins being parallel. So what happens a lot in the squat is people will come down and they'll hinge too much in the hip here. Or they'll go too straight and they'll go into their knees. And so we want all of that to go away. We want the ankle, the knee, and the hip to work together at the exact same time. So as I go into this squat, I'm going to keep a good posture here in my upper back. But see how I'm just collapsing it? I am moving forward a little bit, but I'm not bending from the hip. It's just hinging, just like everything else. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna go down slow, 1,001, 1,002, come back up. What I want you guys focused on is here, here, and here. I want you focus there and feeling that. As we go through this, I'm not sure what you guys were taught when you were coming through and learning, if anybody's ever been taught lifting before. One of the things I was always taught that I found as I was older is wrong, is when we squat or clean or any of that stuff, we were always taught to look up like this. The reason that's wrong, the nerves in your neck and your jaw are actually the same nerves from a communication standpoint as your pelvis. So if you've ever watched anybody squat with their head and they go like this, and they get down and they do that before they come up, that's why that's happening, because you're telling your brain to do that. So that's where lower back problems start. And then because of that, we end up rolling to the toes like this. We put an undue pressure on our knees. We're squatting like this. We have all this. That's why you have all this. So that's the whole point. We don't want to be rocking forward into our toes. We want to have a nice flat foot grabbing the platform. So I'll give you the count. We'll go down, hold, and go up. We'll do this 8 times. You're not expecting you to go very low. I just want here, hold it. 1,001, 1,002, come up. You guys ready? Okay, here we go. We're going down. Hold it right there. 1,001, 1,002, come back up. Sit back into the hips. Make sure that goes down. And we're going down. Sit back. Heels on the ground. And up. That's 2. Let's go. Sit. Up. Good job. Breathe. Keep the abs engaged. Go. Down. Up. Good. Go. Sit into it. And up. 5. 3 more. Down. Up, good. Squeeze those knees straight. Use those adductors. Keep Keep everything straight. Don't let it bow open. Sit. Up. One more. Go. Sit. Perfect. Up. Okay, check that out. So all we're trying to get to do, again, before we get into any resistance, we want to make sure that the movement pattern is set up, that your brain's going, okay, feel good. I know what we're doing here. No questions. And then once you add resistance, that's when you get the better reaction from your brain. So we never want to go into something without having done it. Right? It's just like when you're about to go into a race and run full speed. Never get into a race without having already run full speed. It's a huge misconception. Ever. Like it's never ever. So now we're going to do a lunge. So we're going to do a step back. Now, on the step back, we're not trying to be like super long here. So I don't want you to step all the way back and do all this stuff. All we're doing is taking a light step back. One foot stays right on top of the logo. Do not move your foot from that logo. Reason for that. If and when I have a bar or handles or something in my hand and I have pressure on that, that's gonna move. So anytime we're engaged and we're doing something, your foot stays on top, right? All the time. So why we're practicing it right now. So the position that I'm looking for, and again, I'll do it sideways so you can see what I'm talking about. As I step back, I want to be able to kneel down on the platform. That's all the distance I'm looking for. Reason for that is I'm trying to still get into that squat position. I really want to get my butt and my hamstring in a good position and not have it so far extended that I don't have any power down there. So as I come down, I get into my position. You can even stop here and then literally go straight down. Boom. Up, bring it back. Now as you get into a rhythm, now you can have some rhythm to it. But the whole point is we don't want to break that movement, because now if you break that movement and I go too far back, I can go forward into my knee, or I might go back like this and lose my balance. So it's really important that you just take that small little step, pause, find your balance, go straight down. Now I want to do five on each side. So you can either stay on one leg the whole time, or just make sure you come back to center every time you switch. Go for it. You don't have to go very far. You don't have to go all the way down. You can go halfway like you did before. And I want you to think about your knee going straight down. Yep. Right in front of your hip. Go straight down, right in front of your hip. Very good. Very good, very good. Keep those abs engaged. Shin and spine parallel. Five each side, so yeah, 10 total. So then, once you are done, what we are going to do to make it easy, so we have these carabiners right here, the black carabiners. So you're gonna take them off the hand. Some of you guys have them on handles and some of them might be on the bar. So all you're gonna do is you're gonna clip into, there's a second screw-in carabiner on your bar. So you're gonna take this and just put it on the other carabiner on your bar. And then what you're gonna do is, whether it's the light orange or the skinny orange, the extra light, you're gonna put just one part of it underneath your platform. So just like that. So just pick up your platform, grab that extra light, and just put it right underneath. You can use that one out. Yeah, we're gonna switch that for you.
Challenge me.
So now we're going to go through some exercises and just kind of feel what it feels like. So first one we're going to do is the RDL, so Romanian deadlift. So we're going to stand up nice and tall. So point here is, again, feet are about where we were on the squat, maybe a hair more narrow. So it's almost like you're covering that circle and you can only see the A3 between your arches. Now the whole point here is that we're hinging from the hips. Let me turn this like a skateboard. Okay, so what we're going to do is, first things first is I want the upper back engaged. So it's like someone's putting a finger in the middle of your upper back. Then what you're going to do is to have a slight knee bend, but it doesn't go anywhere beyond that. It stays right where that is, and you hinge from your hip. And this is where you want to keep the bar tight to your body, which is the advantage of this, because in a free weight, you can get away from your body very easily, and that's when the people's back start getting hurt. So all you're going to do is go right below your knees. You're going to come down, sit back into the hip, like you're opening the door with your booty, and then come right back up. Bump the door open. Keep your back tight. Come right to your knee and come up. We're going to do 8 of those. All the way down right below the knee. You should feel that in your hamstrings. You guys feel that in your hamstrings? And it's almost like you're rolling your legs out. Don't let it get away from your body. And once you've done 8, you can put the bar down. Good. Squeeze that upper back. You want to feel that whole posterior chain turn on. Very good. Very good. So I want you guys thinking about too, you can feel how the resistance starts to lessen once you get lower, but then feels really good once you get up here. Okay, so once you're done, you put that down. Yeah. And again, you can go heavy if you want. Okay, so the next one we're gonna do is just a regular deadlift. So we'll start high. We're gonna squat now, right, and keep it right below our knees. And we'll stand up. So the way this one's gonna work, and I'm gonna keep most of it horizontal like this so you guys can see the body angles of what I'm doing. So I'm gonna start up here. Now I'm gonna go a little bit more into a wider stance where I can see the entire sticker between my feet where we were doing the squat. Now, same idea that we did in the bodyweight squat, that I want that upper back tight and I want that shin and spine parallel, but now it's ankle, knee, hip, all working together to come right below the knee and straight back up. Right below the knee and straight back up. Now what you have to be careful for is remember that you have force on you up here, so it is wanting to go down. Even though it gets less down there, it is still wanting to be pulled down. So when you're doing a movement like this, you just have to be cognizant of what you're doing from a movement timing standpoint, because you don't want to come down and go bang and hit your knees. So make sure you're going slow on the way down. And this is where, you know, a big advantage of working out like this is that eccentric motion of going down, where a lot of people struggle in free weights is that going slow and control on the way down, so you're in the perfect position. That's the eccentric side of the movement, and then the concentric is the extension of going up. So as we go into flexion, nice and slow, nice and controlled, boom. You get there, you feel the resistance is gone. Come up. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna do 8 of those. Squeeze that upper back. Take your time on the way down. Even think like a 3, 2, 1 on the way down. Good. And then as you go down, eyes go down. As you go up, eyes go up.
Yep.
Good. And if anyone wants to add a little weight, they can. Just keep it nice and tight.
Just
body
bring it up. Put 2 bands underneath the platform.
Yeah. Looks really good though. Good. A little bit more hip bottom. Yeah. You guys feel that back here? And your hips are probably a little bit too. Good. And once you've done your 80, sit down. You guys like it so far? It's probably better than you thought it was going to be. But can you feel that and that? So I'm going to change mine to this If you don't have this one on, let's put this one on real quick. Everybody just have the lighter band on. If you don't have it on, put it on. I'm gonna do a couple. I'm gonna show you the versatility without going too heavy. And I want you to feel what it feels like with the light band. Elbows and wrists need to be in line. Don't let that move out of the position. So
As you press up, everything stays in line. Take it slow on the way down. Push it up, becomes slow on the way down. And if you want a little bit of an extra burn, when you get up there, just give yourself a 1 second hold. So come up and squeeze your upper back and your shoulders, that was a one, and then come back down. And it actually feels pretty good. There you go, five. Very good, focus on the abs. Feet are flat on the ground.
Nice,
very good. How's it feel?
Like that.
Okay, so now, after you've done your five, so now if you think like any squat variation that can possibly come to your mind, whether this bar's on your back or it's racked on your front, so I'm not gonna ask you to do both, but we can rack it here and have it controlled. Anybody familiar with power cleans? We can teach you power cleans on this in a controlled setting. What I mean by that is power cleans, you know, you're coming off the ground, you get into this position, you actually kind of do a little bit of a row, but if we use our hips, I can come up and come underneath it and clean it. I'm not gonna ask you to do that right now. I'm just showing you that the versatility of this is really cool, and there's so much you can do from a learning perspective that will make you so much more confident, especially if you end up, you know, you wanna do like a hybrid where you're doing this and that and this and that. So on the squat, we can either hold it here or we can bring it up over our head and just put it on our back. Now we can go through full ranges of motion on our squat. So if you feel comfortable putting it over your head and on your back, try it, because it feels actually really good. And we'll do bottom squats. So what a bottom squat is you're gonna, today we'll just go to that half squat that you were doing when we warmed up, and then you just move into a flexion. So you're coming here, you just go up about 6 inches and come back down. Just feel that in your hips and your quads. Now obviously in your glutes and hamstrings, but you're gonna feel the burn in your quads and your hips. Just do, you want to do 10 of those. So keep your knees and toes straight. Sit back into it. Don't come all the way up. Just come down and hold it. Go up and down like a six inch flexion. Great job. You start feeling all this kind of go on fire. Feels good, huh? But think about this like it's a variation, as a supplement to that. It's really cool.
Be careful when you release it.
So anybody feels like being adventurous, you might feel like being adventurous. We'll only do a couple reps, just so you feel. Okay, so you can either do it like this, or do what you just did, or you have it here, and we're going to do the step back. So foot in the middle, come halfway down, and come back up and see what that feels like. Feel the control of your abs and your glutes. And keep your foot on the platform. But as you do this, I want you to think about, you know, 3 to 5. If you want to do 5, do it. If you want to do 3. But just make sure your foot stays on top of that platform, nice and controlled on the way down. Take your time. Great job. And feel those abs working. And then think about that hamstring and glute getting really long on that front leg. Go straight down. As soon as you find your position, just go straight down. And then when you're done, set down. The way the band works, I mean, we can even go into full front raises. I mean, there's so much stuff that we can do. We did some rotational stuff. Another one that feels really good that we'll try real quick before we switch it to the handles is we are sitting on the ground, and we, you know, the little sliders you use in like aerobics and stuff like that. So we have 10 sets of those to go with all of these. So came up with a movement that's going to be like a full body movement. You can hold this here, and then you're going back and forth and keeping your abs engaged as you do this. And then another one is if we either have this or the handles, and you put a med ball behind you as an aiming point, and then you can sit back into the med ball and then come up and press. there's, again, a lot of cool things to do. So, unclip your bar. And now what you're going to do is you're going to put both of the pieces of the band under, and you'll have a little loop hanging out. And then what you'll do is you'll take the carabiner off your bar, put it on the handle, and then clip the handle into that little loop. If you have questions, just holler. Heavier like Rick's doing here, we can still do all of our deadlifts, all of our RDLs, all of our step back lunges, all the stuff we've already done. But now you can start getting into some of that upper body stuff that's really fun. So just as an example, just going into a curl, this can be actually kind of heavy. You can go in and do a couple reps, and it's like, whoa, that's kind of surprising, right? But it's interesting, like putting it underneath compared to the one with the bar where that felt like, oh, that's really easy. You do this, like, oh, kind of burns a little bit. I like that, right? So that's really cool that we can do that. Now, one of the fun things that we've been doing is, one, you could come up and you could hold it up here and we do all of our squats, all of our front rack stuff. This won't be an option for everybody, but you can also do some overhead press and it actually gives you a pretty good burn. But the way we fix that is you put one on the ground and the handle actually fits perfectly and it stops right there. So you have a stop. Everybody do that. Put one on the ground and hold one. Yes. Right. Huh? Yeah, it's not going anywhere. Trust me, I've done it hundreds of times at this point. So you can hold here and you can do single arm presses. And it feels pretty good, right? Now, another thing we can do is come back. No, you don't need to do this. I'm just showing you. We go back into a single-sided lunge, press, and stand up, and then bring it down. Now, a couple other things we can do is cross over here. Now we have that cross symmetry thing, and now you're coming up and doing a wide out that way, yep. And coming all the way out. Yep, but now you can also do a pull and bring it right to the outside of your head like you're starting a lawnmower. Yep. Now, pretty cool, right? Yeah, it's pretty interesting. So then you go back and grab it. Now you can cross them over like this. Now we can go back into the bent over row. So you're here and you pull it right to your armpits. And you can feel that tension and squeeze right into your upper back, but squeeze your abs too, right? Then you can stand up and we can go upright row and pull right to your chin and your chest. And then you can also do rows. So this is where it gets a little tricky depending on, you know, strength levels and all that, but you can go here and pull out, that gets really super heavy. So then you can put the one down and come all the way out like a crossover fly, then coming all the way out on the same, it's hard, huh? So there's some really cool things that we can do here, and it opens up just a plethora of exercises because we can go here, we can keep it on that one side, and we can do lat raises, we can go front raise. So there's a lot of really cool things we can do. So then if you think about from a fitness standpoint, when we have a timer on, and now all of a sudden we're going, okay, we got 20 seconds here, you're going for a full 20 seconds, and then you switch, you got 10 seconds to switch, boom, grab that one. So it's fully functional all the way through. But if you think about even the movement of a class, some of you that have done some of these classes or even watched some of these classes down here, there are gonna be days where we have a major movement as the point of the workout. So for example, so let's say there's four exercises. only one or two of them will be on the platform. So we might be going into an RDL, we're doing that for 20 seconds, but then we grab a med ball and we do some like squat and press, and then we go into a hip or an ab, but maybe the ab is down here on the band or whatever that is. You go through a